Proton and electron repels each other when they get too close, keeping each other at a distance to maintain their own sync equilibrium. However, sometimes, proton and electron can get so close that belt borrows so much momentum from proton electron that it becomes stronger than proton electron and reluctant to return momentum. Maximizing belt attraction, minimizing cost repulsion, proton electron get put together and fused. The belt becomes the main configuration, the neutron. N electron and N proton's core are minimized, with extensions fused together as one. Thus, N electron and N proton can significantly affect each other's configuration, exchanging their frequency and density, fluctuating between the likes of proton-electron pair and antiproton-antielectron pair constantly. So neutron by itself is unstable, weak but definite repulsion of N electron and N proton, and polarization of frequency will decay a free neutron quickly. In such cases, surrounding configuration will likely catalyze N electron to electron and proton to proton. Neutron attraction. When proton meets an unstable neutron at nucleus distance, N electron and proton attracts, and N electron borrows momentum from N proton to bind proton. Neutron is stabilized when connected to a proton, with N electron being the dominant side. N electron-proton connection is immensely closer and stronger than electron-proton connection. Because electron-proton starts repelling each other at close distances. N electron-proton joint is so strong that it overcomes proton-to-proton repulsion 1-to-1. Neutron can also connect a stable neutron to stabilize itself, although the effect is weaker. Without proton, neutron-to-neutron joint is almost instantly untied, because multiple neutrons synchronizing to each other's alternating rhythm is near impossible. Any N-electron-N-proton pair separation will tear apart all connected neutrons. Electron cannot connect to N-proton because electron is too dispersed, and cannot focus enough to detect N-proton. N electron and N proton do not destroy each other. Neutron's belt configuration requires maintaining a minimum N proton and N electron. The belt absorbs from proton and electron, but also sustains them, keeping them at positions to maintain belt's trajectories. And N protons and N electrons' momentum and frequency are usually polarized. N electron and proton do not destroy each other. N electron and proton do not have the same momentum and frequency, thus they cannot unconfigure each other in one swift action, allowing configuration to regenerate themselves faster than destroying each other. Unconserved charge generates synchronized extensions. That is how it attracts opposite charge. Conserved charge generates unsynchronized extensions. Unsynchronized extensions are neutralized trajectories and diminishing nodes. Matter and antimatter unsynchronize entire configurations, conserving charge conclusively. Nucleus structure. When stabilized, neutron-to-neutron connections are stronger than neutron-to-proton connections, because neutron-to-neutron can double join at N electron and N proton. So neutron forms a cluster of neutrons in the center of the nucleus. But neutrons do not like to connect to too many neutrons, because field density will be too high, and it blocks N electron to proton connections, which is required to stabilize the neutron. And too many neutron to proton connections increases proton to proton repulsions. To balance interaction with surrounding and neutron sphere, protons tend to pair up with opposite spins, with same distance from connected N electron, on opposite sides of the neutron sphere. Protons need to avoid other protons, resulting in protons connecting to neutron sphere in different distances. So in the nucleus, neutrons form neutron sphere at the center, protons cling at perimeters of neutron sphere at different distances, forming the proton sphere. N electron and N proton, neutron to neutron, N electron and proton can join horizontally or vertically. Access proton. Proton without adequate N-electron connection will extend. Increased attraction towards electron, increased repulsion towards other protons. Proton in carbon 11 needs more neutrons. Absorbing excess momentum from the nucleus, proton generates an electron-anti-electron pair. The anti-electron is emitted as beta blast decay, and proton fuses with the electron to become neutron, and joins the nucleus, which becomes a nucleus of boron 11 atom. Sometimes, proton transfer momentum to the belt, increasing attraction towards electron in the first shell, pulling it close enough to form a neutron. This is the process of electron capture. Excess neutron. Neutron in carbon 14 is quite stable. However, sometimes its fluctuations are strong enough that N proton absorbs enough momentum from the belt to expel N electron. N proton becomes proton, N electron becomes electron. The nucleus becomes nitrogen 14, which is even more stable. Neutron to proton and proton to neutron conversion is much more common than neutron and proton emission. This illustrates how interconnected are fuel systems in an atom, capable of altering an imperative fuel system's fundamental configuration even before expelling it. Trajectories feeding into each other's system, transferring and borrowing momentum, sometimes even altering configurations, is the reason for such phenomenon. Nitrogen's 14 nucleus, right after beta minus decay, is not in the most energy conserving trajectories yet. Rearranging the nucleus to more energy conserving trajectories, higher stability configuration, releases excess momentum as gamma ray. To maintain all connected fuel systems at sync equilibrium, shortest and simplest trajectories equals lowest energy level, most conserving state, which is the most stable. Longer or more complicated trajectories equals higher energy level, which is more unstable. Extra momentum, if absorbed, forces configuration to adapt. For example, higher electron orbitals, atom vibrations, inefficient trajectories, etc., which will always try to settle down. Neutron can connect to other neutrons in all sites. In polonium 210, neutron forms multi-layer structure. Some neutrons are trapped by other neutrons, increasing its fuel density tension, fluctuation tendency, and proton-to-proton repulsion, causing polonium 210's nucleus to be very unstable. With some disturbance, polonium 210 ejects 2 neutron, 2 proton, and alpha particle, becoming lead-206. Thus, strong and weak force adjust derivatives of fuel momentum interaction. They are effects of fuel momentum responding to different circumstances and not fundamental force. Strong force equals stable configuration of momentum trajectories in nucleus. Weak force equals unstable configuration. A nucleus can be unstable due to 1. Inaccurate neutron-proton ratio. 2. Inefficient trajectories. 3. Oversized nucleus.